So I want to talk about coming out and how it isn't the one-time experience that we often see in the media, because I've done it many times in many different ways to different people with different identities. So here's one for you. I'm Kat and I'm a queer woman. Thank you. Thank you. Wasn't really pausing for that. I like that. All right. Okay. We'll see if I can get another one. All right. There are so many labels in the LGBTQ alphabet soup, essentially. It goes on and on. And I want to talk to you about where I sit in that and how I've come to be where I am now, because I've worked my way through the spectrum. And some of that has been because I have changed as I've grown and gone older and had more life experiences, how I identify has changed. But it's also been because at times in my life, I've been too ashamed to admit who I am to other people, to myself included. And that shame tends to come from a society that I grew up in the 90s. So my role models on television were Will and Grace and Ellen DeGeneres. And if you were queer like them, great. But if you weren't, that's not okay. And you'd better be funny if you are queer. So I struggled to come out. I started about 10 years ago. And I started by telling a few of my friends that I was bisexual. And I wasn't. I was a lesbian. I knew this at the time. But it felt like a way to test the waters to see what their reaction would be. Now, I really regret saying that now, because that does a disservice to those that genuinely identify as bisexual, who face the assumption from misguided individuals that perhaps they are just indecisive. And to be bisexual is an equally valid orientation as any other, and it deserves that respect. It was also a disservice to my friends, who were, of course, completely wonderful. And they wouldn't be my friends if they weren't. So I became happier in who I was, and my internalized shame got a bit smaller, and I became comfortable to refer to myself as gay. And now note that I say gay and not a lesbian, because there's something about the language of gay and lesbian. You can be gay. It's a part of your identity. But you can't be lesbian. You have to be a lesbian, which feels much more like a label, something that is easier to objectify. And while both terms historically have been used as insults, and we have moved past that now, mostly, that distinction between being and being a was one that I wasn't then ready to take. The shame was still there, clearly. And to be honest, I don't actually know what happened. There was no big event that sparked the change. I think it might have just been a slow erosion of my own mental barriers over time. But at one point, it just became very easy to say, I am a lesbian, and not go, I'm a lesbian. So it's very happy to go, oh, I'm gay, it's great. And then all of a sudden, like, I'm a lesbian, this is fantastic. And it was great, the shame had gone. And in some weird twist, I now have a level of shame inside me that I was ever ashamed to feel that shame in the first place. Maybe that will go at some point or other, I don't know. But it's kind of inception shame. So there I was, happy as a lesbian. And then I met my partner, Steph. So Steph is trans non-binary, and their pronouns are they, them. And it took me a little while to get used to using that language, because we are used to using them as plurals. I remember chatting to Jackie when I first started dating Steph, and I was like, oh, and then yeah, we went out to lunch, and they bought me a nice coffee, and Jackie's like, how many people are you dating? Okay. But it came to me eventually, and probably actually quite quickly being able to use they, them, because to me, Steph is a person, and I don't see them as a man or a woman. When someone refers to them as her or him, it sounds wrong to me, because they're Steph, their partner, and I love them. And so I had to rethink my label again, because with lesbian being a woman who's attracted to other women, having a trans non-binary partner, lesbian didn't feel right anymore. It was too constrictive. It was a constraining label. So now I say I'm queer, or I am a queer. I'm still happy to slap a label on that. Interestingly, having a partner who is trans non-binary has required me now to come out in ways that I never used to before. So last summer I met a man on a train, and I have one of those faces that says to people on public transport that they can sit next to me and they should definitely start a conversation. If anyone knows how I stop my face from saying that, do come up afterwards and let me know. He came up and he asked, he's like, we got chatting. He's like, oh, so why are you going down to London? And I said, well, I'm going to go see my partner. They're doing a research internship down there. And he asked, oh, well, what are you planning to do there? I said, well, I'm going to take them out to lunch. And he picked up on my use of they, them pronouns. And he wrongly assumed that I was there for a lesbian, but one not comfortable enough to use gendered pronouns of my partner. Because if I was straight, I would have said he and him. And if I was out and proud, I would have said she and her. And I'd essentially been put back into the closet, not of my own volition, and I had to talk my way out of it by giving a lesson on gender diversity on the Hull to King's Cross train. Now, this wasn't actually an uncomfortable experience. He was very pleasant. It was just something new to him. He was happy to learn about it, and I'm sure to some of you in this room, this will be new too. But it says a lot about how society does make assumptions. Right now, people will generally assume, unless they are told otherwise, that you are straight. They will insist that you have a label of some sort. And if you take anything away from this talk, I want it to be that you stop automatically assuming that people are cisgendered and heterosexual. And if someone has got a label, don't think that it's a static one as well. Simply appreciate people for who they are, when they are, and enjoy the spectrum. Thank you.